how to set up a connection for a smart transmitter. So in this video, we're going to use a differential pressure transmitter. So what we have here is our transmitter and the handheld communicator, a 475 field communicator, and a multimeter that will check our milliamp output. Okay, so here at the back, in the terminal side of the transmitter, you can see there are three terminals. So it is labeled plus, power, and minus. At the same time, it is the communication terminal. In the middle, and this one is for test. That means it is where we could connect our milliamp meter. Okay, so now we will connect this transmitter to the power supply. So check the power supply. There are four terminals. The other pair is smart TX, and the other one is normal supply. So we will connect this one to smart TX. So the difference is smart TX, it's having a series resistance at the back of this power supply panel. So that is a loop resistance. So we will talk about it in the other session. So okay, we'll connect the positive and negative here. Alright, so once we will turn on that power supply, we can check the transmitter is powering up. But since the transmitter doesn't have a local display, so we can check it out by connecting our output. So our transmitter will put it in the milliamp selection. Okay, so it is easy. Press this yellow to make it DC and transfer this probe to the appropriate terminal. Yeah, so milliamp. Okay, now so we're gonna connect it directly to the terminals on the test. So positive here and negative here. So see, now our milliamp output is 12 milliamp. That means it is in the 50%. So this transmitter is new, so we'll have to set it up using our communicator. Okay, let us check whether if it is communicating now. So here it is online, then either click this one. Now it is communicating, right? So there are three options: overview, configure, service tools. So let us see the overview. By the way, this is Rose Mount transmitter. So when you are navigating to the options or parameters or something, you just press this one down and up selections. Then if you want to see this particular option, so just press this one like that. But since this is, we cannot modify something, this is only a read only, so we're gonna exit. Then to go back, also is this one. Yeah, so overview, see the pressure, actual pressure is 0.1, a unit is inches, it's 2.0. So analog output is 12 milliamp. Why? Because the upper range value by default and the lower range value is negative 250 and 250 in its toe. So since this is zero, so it is in the mid. So 12 milliamp, this is 50%. Okay, so we're gonna connect our current meter. Current meter, so right, positive here in the test terminals. So have you wondered that we are measuring current, but we are directly connecting it. So as principle, that current has to be placed in series with the power supply so that we can measure the current flow. But why we directly connected the probes to the terminals and we get the current of the output. So just a tip, just a trivia, there is a diode inside the circuit. So while connecting these probes directly to the terminal, to the test terminal, we are bypassing actually the diode in it. Okay, so the diode serve as like as a reversal polarity. At the same time, we can connect our current meter directly without interrupting the power supply. All right, so again, disconnected, maybe it's okay. So this is how we set up the physical connection of the transmitter using our hard communicator and milliamp meter. Hard communicator, it is connected parallel to the power supply. The meter is connected to the test terminal. All right.